Freitagnachmittag mit und bei NBC Giga und den Sparks. Welcome here in our new media studio, Ron and Russell.
Thanks. Thank you.
Hope you're feeling fine. Everything's all right?
We're feeling fine. So far.
Oh. I mean, a little hot and sweaty. Your country's even hotter than our country.
Yes, you're right. Our air conditioning is not working that well. Perhaps that's the reason why.
Exactly.
We have your website, your personal website, but it's not really your personal website, but a fan site.
Right, it's by a bunch of Sparks fans from Holland. They set up a website before we were able to set up our own official website. So there's going to be an official Sparks website in about a month and a half. But mm-hmm. for the time being, there's this other one that's a really good site. It's very extensive, has all kinds of discographies about the band and things you can buy and things you can trade and all sorts of stuff like that.
And you already surfed it through so that you can present it to us?
Yeah. I think I know some of it.
That would be great.
Should I go ahead. Show you now some of the, let's see. Well, it's got the welcome to the fan mail website. Our last name is M-A-E-L, so obviously there's the pun, whatever. So it's got all of these topics. Let's see, it's got, they're actually, the headings are all named after album titles of the band. So it's got
nice
propaganda.
Idea.
There's the different ones. So Important. That's actually a song title of ours. Rock and Roll People in the Disco World. Gone with the Wind. So you can go to any one of these. They're calling them tracks.
Yeah.
And you can find out something about the band. So here we'll go to Pulling Rabbits Out of a Hat, which was a Sparks album title of a few years back.
Yeah.
And see what happens. And what happens?
You get
a full Sparks discography with 7-inch vinyl singles, 12-inch vinyl singles, vinyl albums, CD singles, CD albums, collaborations we've done, unreleased, covers by others. So let's see, we can go to CD albums and see what they have there. Mm-hmm.
That's a nice idea to name the certain subjects by the titles of your albums you had.
And then you go there, and these guys are so detailed in what they have. They've got Best of Sparks. There's all the different things you can get. And they even have different versions of our albums mm-hmm. from different countries, too. So they've got the UK, the US version, the Japanese version.
Yeah.
And the list kind of goes on and on and on and on and on. So as you can see, Sparks has had a lot of albums.
Yeah, Ron, how does it feel to have fans like him, perhaps, who does such a big effort to create a website just for you?
Oh, it's flattering. They're a bit obsessive, and sometimes it's a bit frightening. But and occasionally there's some misinformation. But
really?
It's the only downside to the whole sort of internet kind of affair is that people believe everything they read, and there's a lot. There are things that occasionally are put on here that aren't true. But
you can correct it on your own. Side.
That's right.
That's right.
How about your internet habits? Do you surf a lot?
Just mainly pornography sites. That's the main thing. But apart from that, we're really not interested in the internet that much.
Yeah.
No.
How about emails?
Yeah, email. We both have got our own email things. You have to have like at least 5 different email names or
address.
Exactly, so that you can go and do things that you wouldn't do normally under your own name. That's the obvious, duh. Like everybody does that.
People you care about and people you really don't care that much about. You know.
Okay, so. I see.
Let me try to find something else here while we're here. What else do they have?
Do you know what's hidden behind the titles, or do you just
actually,
try out?
I don't know all that much because I'm kind of, I'm not that interested in looking to see what all is on our very own site.
Yeah.
But here's things you can see is the official Sparks fan club. There's another guy who publishes a fanzine in England.
That's great.
Let's see, what else do we got on here? We'll go to something else. Happy Hunting Ground.
There we will have the pornography site.
Yeah, I wish. But
Sparks in very revealing poses.
Here it tells about all.
You guys can check it out if you want to surf to this fan site from Sparks. Sie sind hier in der nächsten Stunde. Ihr könnt eure Fragen stellen im Chat unter giga.de oder aber per E-Mail an sparks@giga4u.de. Have fun.
Beispiel dazu. Willi sorgt jetzt quasi auch dafür, dass meine Stimme gut gekühlt ist, um euch ganz schnell zu sagen, was in den nächsten 30 Minuten hier passiert. Wir haben The Sparks zu Gast. When Do You Get to Sing My Way? Das ist so der Song, der mir spontan in den Kopf kommt, wenn ich The Sparks höre. Sie haben ein neues Stück, More Than a Sex Machine, und dazu werden sie hoffentlich gleich noch ein kleines bisschen was erzählen. Außerdem startet am Sonntag eine neue Saison der NFL, der National Football League, und das ist natürlich eine Nummer, der sich Chris von Sport and Fun ganz und gar gewidmet hat. Außerdem könnt ihr chatten, e-mailen, euch im Netbeat oder bei Help, bei den Games, wo auch immer, gerne beteiligen. Was ihr jetzt genau tun solltet, das ist eine E-Mail schreiben an team@giga4u.de und dann in die Betreffzeile einen Videowunsch. Irgendwie sowas wie, weiß nicht, I like ice cream, wenn ihr möchtet.
Na gut, Willi, vielen Dank für das tolle Eis. Smarties sind drin und so, ganz toll. Und ich bin nicht der Einzige, der hier was genießen soll. Ihr sollt auch was davon haben. Schaut mal uns auf die Website. Da gibt es einen Button, der heißt Win. Und es gibt ja was zu gewinnen in Spotify. Wollen wir doch mal gucken, wo ist es denn, dieser Gewinn? Warum habe ich den denn nicht gesehen? Seht ihr, so kann es euch gehen, ne? Wenn der Moderator das noch nicht mal findet, go win, das muss doch da sein. Verflixter Hund. Wo ist denn das? Das nicht, das ist eine CD von Sparks, das auch nicht. Wir wollen uns aber einem anderen Thema widmen, das uns natürlich ganz besonders hier in Deutschland berührt, denn in den Staaten, in den USA, geht am Sonntag die NFL-Saison los. Und das ist natürlich insofern auch sehr interessant. Der legendäre Quarterback und sein Nachfolger bei den Denver Broncos, das ist ein ganz, ganz unbekannter Mann. Der heißt Brian Greasy, ist 24 Jahre alt, ist noch nicht lange vom College weg, kommt aus Michigan und hat in der Preseason in, lass mich nicht lügen, ich habe es mir genau aufgeschrieben, in 3 Preseason-Games 4 Touchdown-Pässe geworfen, hatte aber auch eine Interception und 2 Sacks. Also, Tom meint, funktioniert oder auf jeden Fall kann ich da jetzt gerade nicht zuhören. Will ich euch noch die Site der Minnesota Vikings zeigen, denn bei den Vikings ist es so, dass die Buchmacher die Vikings als ganz, ganz großen Favoriten ansehen. 9-2 werden die gehandelt und wir wollen sehen, ob sie es schaffen. Letztes Jahr hatten sie ein bisschen Pech. Sie starten auf jeden Fall mit einem Knallerspiel gegen die Vikings am Sonntag. Was glaubt ihr? Kann dieser Brian Greasy den legendären John Elway so schnell ersetzen? Und was glaubt ihr? Wer sind die Favoriten in der diesjährigen NFL-Saison? Sagt es mir im Sport in Funchat unter giga.de oder auch gern per Mail an christian@giga4u.
Ron und Russell, besser bekannt vielleicht als The Sparks, sind bei uns hier bei NBC Giga zu Gast. Over 25 years in Showbiz. Is that now a time to say or to sing My Way?
You know, actually, that theme-wise, that's sort of the was the idea of that song. Just someone wanting to know when, after his entire life, when he's going to get to do things his own way. And in fact, using the metaphor of the song, the famous old song, My Way, when he'll get his 10 minutes of fame or 10 minutes of whatever. So, yeah, that was sort of the theme of that tune.
Yeah. If you look back 25 years or 20 years or 15 years, what do you think is the biggest change you made or the biggest difference compared to your former life or to the beginning of being in showbiz?
Well, computers have actually been the biggest change in what we've been working with, because originally it was 5 people sitting in a studio just playing, and now we sit in front of the little machine and I play the keyboards, and that's kind of the way we work. So
doesn't that feel strange?
It feels very strange, and at first you think it's impersonal, but then you realize that it's just another way to record. You have to get over the fact of it seeming like just computerized, you know, and it's just another way to work.
Yeah.
And the great thing about it is that anybody can do it. That it's democratized the recording process, where before bands had to have 100,000 Mark budgets to record an album, and now anybody at home can do it, and that's a great thing.
And personally, when you look into yourself and you see the development you've made or you've been through, what is the biggest difference or the biggest change you made personally? If you want to tell it.
The biggest change personally. Take the mic.
Yeah.
After 25 years, I haven't learned that you have to speak into the microphone in order to be heard.
It's this end, not this end.
I would have to say, nothing's changed for me. I don't know. You answer the question.
We're so locked into doing what we're doing that we kind of, any kind of changes are so evolutionary that we can't even tell kind of what's
changes
going on.
Changes are horrible, aren't they?
Well, they are, yeah, but we're really isolated, so we don't kind of see changes.
So you're living like on a lonely island without anybody else around you?
Well, actually we are, because we're totally self-contained when we record. We have a studio in my house, and we shut ourselves up in there for ages, and it's a lonely it can be a lonely profession. People think it's all a lot of glamour and all that sort of thing, but you know, you have to just shut yourself away and
live from junk food, which is brought right to your door.
We try to stay away from junk food, but
that's good.
We have salads delivered to us.
Yes,
to
and salads.
Ich möchte ein Salat mit der Dressing nicht auf dem Salat, aber
daneben. Perfect.
Bitte.
Yes.
Zweimal. Es hat gemündet.
Oh, that's quite perfect. These are at least the most important things in German.
That's right.
So you don't suffer from hunger. It's great. And if you look into future, the next 25, I don't know how many years, what shall happen? I don't know what. UFOs coming down, taking you up to another world, or something quite normal?
I think it's not going to be anything as radical as aliens coming down to take us away. I think it's just, you know, a subtle evolution of things. Because, you know, it's with all the technology and everything that there is now, everyone, you know, is so entranced by all of that. But in the end, it's sort of what you do with the technology and what you do with things. So things like the internet and everything, it's really amazing, and it is a change, and it is the future of what's happening. But in the end, it's kind of back down to the basic elements of the substance, what you do with all of that technology and what you'll do with the future.
And human contact.
Human contact,
human
see?
Human contact. More than a sex machine is the aktuelle Single, darüber sprechen wir gleich.
Die Werbung, man sieht es im Internet ja überall. Und die meisten nervt es, weil die keinen Bock drauf zu gucken haben und so weiter. Aber für viele von euch könnte man vielleicht auch sagen, naja, wenn ich Werbung habe und mit bestimmten Projekten, kann ich auch kostenlos oder vielleicht billiger im Internet surfen. Das ist natürlich...
Sparks sind bei uns zu Gast und das ist Ron. Ron sitzt neben mir, um ein paar eurer Fragen aus dem Chat zu beantworten. Ron, there were really many questions in the chat, and somebody calling himself Insectuate, he wanted to know, in what year did you start making music?
Ooh, that's too embarrassing. Go on to
why,
the next
why,
one.
Why?
That's too embarrassing. Let's just say it was in the late 20th century and leave it at that.
Okay, if you don't want to talk about it, we're going to skip that question.
Our lurid past, yeah.
Richie Vanderloo wanted to know, what do you think about the development in music business? You said it's getting more computerized, but what do you think about development in music business in common?
The business itself?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I think one big problem is that, as we had mentioned, that you can record in a lot cheaper fashion. So much is made now of videos, which cost so much that it's sort of cut down on record companies being able to experiment and just sign interesting music. They have to have such a big investment that they're not taking chances. And I think it's much more conservative than it was in the past. Yeah. It's sad, but that's the case.
Do you think there's more music with low quality nowadays than it was in the past? Okay, but it's very friendly how you say that. Like,
I'm trying to be as diplomatic as possible.
Okay,
but,
very good. Crazy Bug wanted to know. It's a funny question. I know the answer already, but he wanted to know, how long do you two guys know each other? Explain it to Crazy Bug, please.
Well, as luck would have it, we happen to be brothers, so we've known each other for each of our entire lives.
Yeah. So you were the one who made your brother get into music too, or did you get into music at the same time?
Well, in fact, neither of us really had an intention to get into music. Mm-hmm. Russell was studying at film school, and I was studying at art school, and each of us was actually in separate bands, and then at one point we decided to see what would happen if we worked together. The experiment is still going on. We're still not sure whether it's the right thing or not.
Do you think it's more difficult to work with your brother than if you were working with a totally stranger? Do you, like, fight more? Because I have a sister and we're, like, fighting very often.
No, we have discussions, but I think the reason we have been able to continue for so long is the fact that we are brothers. And the arguments that we have are over small things, like different sounds or different rhythms, but it's never over the overall direction of the band because we really like the same kind of music. So I think it's worked to our advantage, even though we have the same squabbles that you and your sister have.
Okay. There was another question from Insectuid. He wanted to know, what do you do in your spare time?
Ooh. Well, to be honest, what we do is so all-consuming time-wise that there isn't a lot of spare time, but I like to watch movies. That's kind of my passion, film. Mm-hmm. And we've actually done some soundtrack work. We did the soundtrack for one Jean-Claude Van Damme movie that nobody's seen called Knock Off that was around a couple of years ago. So we have a passion for film, and we really like doing soundtrack things when we're not working as Sparks.
What was the last movie that you saw?
The last movie I saw, to be honest, it was actually, and it's sort of late in coming to America, but it was Lola Run, the German film, and I thought that was great.
Yeah, I haven't seen it yet.
You haven't?
At the cinema, I saw it on video, but I'd like to see it on the big screen.
Gotta see it on the big screen.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Ron, thank you very much so far.
Pleasure.
Ihr könnt weitere Fragen stellen an die Sparks im roten Stars-Chat unter giga.de.
Ron und Russell sind The Sparks, und The Sparks sind in den nächsten 30 Minuten noch hier bei uns und haben sie einiges vor. Sie werden nämlich spielen, sie werden chatten, sie werden auf der Couch quatschen. Und zwar nur über ein Thema, nämlich über Sex. Außerdem haben wir eine ganz süße Seite für euch rausgesucht, die euch hilft, wenn ihr absolute Festival-Junkies seid. Da könnt ihr nach verschiedenen Kriterien suchen, zum Beispiel nach Bands, die ihr unheimlich gerne Open Air und Live erlebt, oder aber nach der Kategorie Umsonst, wo komme ich kostenlos hin? Und das ist ganz schön aufgemacht mit Anfahrtsbeschreibung, mit Line-Up, sofern schon bekannt, und, wo ihr das Ganze...
Wir fahren eine Runde Sega Rally. Ich bin unten, Russell ist oben. You're ready to start?
I'm ready, but I have my safety belt, but I have to explain first though. I'm from America and we drive slow. We don't have autobahns, so you're gonna kick my butt. You're gonna beat me really bad. So, okay.
This course is not too strong for you.
Okay, here
this
we go.
Is a beginner course.
Beginner course, that's me.
And
oh my god.
You can't fly out of the course.
Okay, that's good news. Oh my god. Whoa!
So, you can see me?
I can see you and you're beating me, but...
This means that you're very fast, if you can see me. You know the sign for the wrong direction?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
I'm going right so far, aren't I?
right? But you prefer using the computer only to make music.
Yeah, as you can tell, I only use it for music, not for driving cars.
Or killing people.
Or killing people. Yeah. I like crashing the walls, though, a lot. As you can see. Oh, there we go.
Killing cars, maybe.
Yeah. It's American style.
Yes?
A little bit drunk, you know.
The Americans are drunken when they're driving cars?
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Hmm.
How much is the bill from the policeman if you're drunken?
Well, you just go straight to jail, so.
Yeah?
Yeah, straight to jail and, I don't know, pay a few hundred dollars, have your license taken away. What was that sound?
So I asked you before, do you like to be compared with the Pet Shop Boys? Because maybe they have got the same, not the same style, but they're as old as you. Sorry for that, but...
Well, it's kind of hard to explain, but, you know, Sparks have been doing what we're doing for probably even a lot longer than they have. And so...
Oh, wrong direction. It's me. Sorry.
You're going the wrong direction?
Yes.
Oh. What was the question again?
Do you like to be compared with them?
No, I hate to be compared to them.
Okay, but this doesn't mean that you hate them.
Oh, no, I don't hate them.
Okay.
I don't hate them at all.
Your favorite is Chemical Brothers?
I like Chemical Brothers. I like Prodigy. I like, you know, Fatboy Slim. I like, you know...
And you told me that you've met not the Chemical Brothers, but...
Prodigy. I won.
Yes.
No, I won.
You won. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you, Russell. Euch sage ich...
You.
Natürlich hat er gewonnen und ich habe mal wieder eine Niederlage einstecken müssen. Alle wichtigen Infos zu unserem großen Thema des Tages, NHL 2000, gibt's nur bei uns auf unserer Homepage und die heißt giga.de, logischerweise.
Da fängt der Typ noch da oben an zu argumentieren. You won, you lose? Jochen, wenn du verlierst, dann gib's gefälligst zu. Dafür gibt's das. Du hast nicht verloren.
Dieser Gamer-Egg wurde wieder platt gemacht. Jochen hat verloren.
Nein, Jochen hat gar nicht verloren. Okay, Jochen, jetzt hast du einen gut. Wenn du das nächste Mal verlierst, spiele ich es nicht. Ist das okay?
Nein.
Ist nicht okay. Was kann ich denn tun? Ich kann nichts weiter tun, als euch auf ein schönes Thema aufmerksam zu machen bei uns auf der Website. Jetzt bin ich aber ganz verlegen. Tom hat es geschrieben, ein großes Preview zur NFL-Saison, die am Sonntag startet. Die 80. ist es und natürlich eine besondere, weil es natürlich die letzte Saison in diesem Jahrhundert ist. Quasi eine Millennium-Saison. Football is coming home, hat er Thomas genannt. Natürlich eine kleine Anspielung auf den englischen Soccer, aber was soll's. Und wir haben im Sport & Fun Chat feste darüber diskutiert. Ist es möglich, dass der Neue bei den Broncos, Brian Greasy, den großen, großen John Elway ersetzen kann? Gute Frage. Ihr hattet einige Antworten. Wie er sich schlägt, der Brian Greasy in der NFL-Saison, die am Sonntag beginnt. Gleich reden wir hier auch um etwas, was beginnt, und zwar heute Abend, nämlich die neue Saison in der deutschen Eishockey-Liga. DEL-Start ist heute und da gibt es einen ganz klaren Favoriten. Und wer das ist, das erzähle ich euch gleich.
Than a Sex Machine. Das ist die aktuelle Single von The Sparks, Ron und Russell. When it's coming out? Has it been already released?
No, the song should be out in a couple of weeks in the shops and stuff, but yeah, so.
You guys ought to buy it.
And there's going to be a video for it soon, so you can see it soon, hopefully.
Yeah, I hope it too. Let's talk about sex.
Yes, let's talk about sex.
Mm-hmm. Finally. Boy,
finally, we get to something 45, interesting.
45 minutes of this music stuff. You know.
Who needs technology, man?
It's yeah, you're right. Go ahead. Tell me whatever you want. I didn't ask anything.
Well, our song, More Than a Sex Machine, since you've asked about that, yeah. We can tell you about how that relates to sex.
Yeah.
It's a song being sung from the point of view of a idol who is glamorous and all of that, but he feels that he wants to be accepted for more than just his physical appearance, and that
sex
he has
symbol.
More to offer. Yeah, so he's saying he's more than a sex machine, even though, in fact, maybe he really isn't more than a sex machine. So it's has the theme to this tune.
But how about the prejudices that men especially are rather often the sex machines in a relationship? Compared to a relationship between a woman and a man. Women always say, oh, no, not today. I got a headache, and you know that stuff.
Well, I don't know. Mm. I've never had a woman say she has a headache around me, so
okay.
I don't know. What can I tell you?
They tend to get, the women that hang around me tend to get a lot of headaches, so I...
But is it like that men are probably a little bit more...